Michael Jordan led the Bulls to the first three-peat in 1993. Then surprisingly, Jordan retired. With number 23 not in a Bulls uniform, there was a two-year window where several high-quality teams had a tremendous opportunity to win a championship. This two-year period has been an interesting era to discuss about what could have been for some teams with Jordan gone. We know who the usual suspects were, but there's one team that is never, and I mean that is never discussed about a missed opportunity during this period. 90 Sports and Soldier presents Forgotten NBA Teams, the 1993-1994 Atlanta Hawks. The 1992-1993 Atlanta Hawks went 43-39, but got swept by the Bulls in the first round of the NBA playoffs. For the following season, Lenny Wilkins would become the new head coach, and there was some talent to work with. Dominique Wilkins was still a member of the Atlanta Hawks at this time, but could still score despite nearing his mid-30s. Mookie Blaylock was a point guard and was arguably one of the best defensive point guards ever. Stacey Augmon was a solid 6'8" versatile player who could be effective on both ends of the floor. Kevin Willis was an underrated power forward who could rebound and score in the post. John Konkak in the middle was basically known as being a decent defender down there, and the bench was decent with the signings of Craig Elo and Andrew Lang. As forementioned, there is some talent here, especially with the foursome of Wilkins, Blaylock, Augmon, and Willis. But is it enough to be a serious title contender? The 1993-1994 Atlanta Hawks started 1-4, but then won their next 14 games. Atlanta continued to play well and was on top of the Eastern Conference with a 34-13 record at the All-Star break. Then about a week and a half later, with a top record in the East, the Hawks made an extremely shocking trade. Atlanta traded their extremely popular all-time leading scorer in Dominique Wilkins and a first-round draft pick to the Clippers for Danny Manning. This was a shocking trade at the time. When looking at this trade afar from the Hawks side and knowing that both of these players would be free agents at the end of the season, the easiest conclusion to make for this trade was the age factor. Dominique was 34 years old and ruptured his Achilles tendon about 2 years earlier. Meanwhile, Danny Manning was younger at 27 years old, an all-star, and seemingly got past his earlier knee problems in LA. But possibly Danny Manning was a much better fit than Dominique in Lenny Wilkins' system. Dominique was very ball dominant, and Manning was more of an overall player. Author Hank Hurst said it best in his SI Vault story when he said Wilkins is 34, a 6'8" true small forward who can fill up the basket. Manning is 27, a versatile 6'10" frontcourt player who can fill up an entire box score. He also stated that Dominique and Kevin Willis would often clash over the ball, while Manning welcomes the help for the scoring load. Lastly, Hurst praised increased ball movement with the addition of Manning. Lenny Wilkins liked that Manning was smart and would make good decisions down the stretch. John Konkak basically stated that Manning gets rid of the ball when he's not open and that makes him a better shooter. Nonetheless, the trade happened and the Atlanta Hawks continued to play well as they finished the 1993-1994 season on top of the Eastern Conference standings. For the NBA playoffs, the top-seeded Hawks would square off against the Miami Heat. This was a tense playoff battle that included a brawl. In a best-of-five series, Atlanta was down 2-1 but would wind up winning the last 2 games to win this series. For the second round matchup, the Indiana Pacers would be coming to town, but unfortunately for the Hawks, Indiana won the series 4-2, with each of Indiana's wins coming by at least 11 points. The top seed in the East would be eliminated, as it would be the Pacers who would face off against the Knicks in a memorable Eastern Conference Finals and not the Hawks. For the offseason, the Hawks would not be restricted by the salary cap and their ability to match any other team's offer to re-sign their own player in Danny Manning. However, Manning would wind up signing with the Phoenix Suns. The Atlanta Hawks would then take a step back, but have some solid seasons after that thanks to some savvy trades. The 1993-1994 Atlanta Hawks seemingly exceeded expectations. Unfortunately, they had a rough end to their season. The 1993-1994 Atlanta Hawks had the best record in the East, but no one talks about them as a team with the missed opportunity to win an NBA championship during Michael Jordan's first retirement. Forgotten NBA Teams, the 1993-1994 Atlanta Hawks.